Well, Israel has maintained that its war is on Hamas and not the people of Gaza, even though nearly 19,000 have been killed there. Many, largely the majority of those are civilians. Israel says that no, it is precise in its bombings. But a new report from the US Director of National Intelligence shows that the kinds of bombs it's using are not precise at all. In fact, they're actually called dumb bombs. That's right. This is according to CNN, nearly half of the air-to-ground munitions that Israel has used in Gaza in its war with Hamas since October 7th have been unguided, otherwise known as dumb bombs. Unguided munitions are typically less precise, can pose a greater threat to civilians, especially in such densely populated areas like Gaza. The rate at which Israel is using the dumb bombs may be contributing to the soaring civilian death toll. I'm extremely surprised and concerned. This is according to Brian Kastner, former explosive ordnance disposal officer who now serves as Amnesty International senior crisis advisor on arms and military operations. He says it's bad enough to be using weapons when they are precisely hitting their targets. It's a massive civilian harm problem if they do not have that accuracy, and if you can't even give a benefit of the doubt to the weapon that the weapon's actually landing where the Israeli forces intended it to. The IDF has a response to this new report. They told CNN that the type of munitions used in each strike is determined according to the characteristics of the target, the operational need, and the effort to mitigate harm to civilians, which the terrorist organization uses as human shields. Yes, if we all had a dollar for every time we heard the human shields line. This is, however, a line that the Biden administration has largely bought. We'll get into a little bit of that. But the real question is, for me, does it matter, right? Precision guided bombs, which supposedly strike their targets more accurately, or these dumb bombs? It seems like civilians are dying no matter what. Again, one of those precision guided bombs was used to target a refugee camp. They've been targeting ambulances with people who are injured trying to leave and flee. So tomato, tomato a little bit to me, Cenk, but this is still like a massive report that says, you know, the kind of indiscriminate bombing that Biden had the gumption to finally say, although it was behind closed doors, it was to his donors, finally had the balls to say this is indiscriminate bombing. Yeah, it's been indiscriminate. And it's sort of by design. I don't even know why the IDF is defending this. If they say they're not targeting civilians, but then they do target civilians, it's the most developed military in the world, and they're the most moral army. They don't target, but they do. But they, it's like whichever way they want to spin it on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, whichever day of the week, they know what they're doing. They know that they're punishing the people of Gaza for the crimes of Hamas, and they just expect us all to, you know, stop talking about it.
So let me tell you why I think that this is indiscriminate killing of civilians. There's a great number of evidence to point to that. Number one, Israel has now dropped over 29,000 bombs in a place that's about the size of Las Vegas. Imagine you're in Las Vegas and another government is dropping 29,000 bombs. I mean, the terror would be unspeakable. Imagine if they dropped 29 bombs on Vegas, let alone 29,000. Second of all, now we find out that no, they're unguided. Nearly half of them are unguided bombs. So that means who cares where they land? I mean, they make these ridiculous claims that, oh, we fly a little bit lower when we drop the dumb bombs.
Right.
Okay, absurd, absurd. Look, this whole thing about, oh, Hamas is hiding behind human shields, etc. For the people in Washington, they think that's clever. To the rest of us, you look absurd when you say that. No one believes your propaganda anymore. So that's gonna go to another point, which is that, as I've pointed out now, and it drives me crazy that the rest of the media doesn't point it out, even though we've all seen the videos. The tunnels are totally unaffected by the bombing. Hamas right. fighters are in the tunnels. And Netanyahu himself on American television said, well, now that we're on the ground, we're finally beginning to have an effect on Hamas. Well, but you'd already dropped over 10,000 bombs by then. So you just admitted that that had no effect on Hamas. So they're dropping bombs and they're not hitting Hamas at all, it appears. And so even when you ask the IDF, and they are the world's biggest propagandists, they still say, well, of the 18,000 civilians killed, maybe 1,000 or 2,000 are Hamas fighters. So that's that means there's no way it's close to 1,000 or 2,000. But even if that were true, that your hit rate is abysmally low because you're not really trying. And then that gets to another point. New York Times did a brilliant job of reporting this. The largest bomb we ever dropped in a residential area in Iraq was 500 pounds. And that was in the heaviest fighting in Mosul. And we were very reluctant and had lots of committees and et cetera before we dropped that bomb, 500 pounds. Israel is dropping 2,000 pound bombs. Again, it's the size of Vegas. They're obliterating everything in their path.
And the most densely populated place on earth.
Yeah.
So the size of Vegas, but the most densely populated.
Yeah, and guys, this is, and New York Times also reported this. They've killed more civilians in 2 months than America killed in Afghanistan in 20 years. More civilians have died in this conflict than all other conflicts combined in all of last year. And IDF has the nerve to turn around and go, oh, it was all an accident. Whoops, did we do it again? Oh, we killed civilians and civilians and civilians. And we're apparently the worst, most inaccurate, buffoonish military. Oh, there goes more civilian deaths. No, guys, they are attempting to kill civilians. You can get upset about that. You can do propaganda if you want. It doesn't matter. We all have eyes, we have ears, we can see it clear as day. And the facts overwhelmingly prove they are not trying to minimize civilian casualties. This is indiscriminate massacre of civilians. And I don't want America funding it at all. I don't think we should send a dollar to Israel from now on. Forget the $14 billion that they want to send. Apparently, we just found out in the defense bill, they send limitless missiles to Israel without even asking Congress, let alone the billions of dollars we send them every year. We should send zero. I do not want my money going to massacre children in Gaza.
Yes, and we also are supplying those dumb bombs to Israel specifically. So we could end the indiscriminate bombing if Biden is more comfortable with discriminate bombing. And we'll get to that in a second. But to the human cost, and I think Cenk summed it up so beautifully. CNN finally doing some real reporting, not behind IDF tanks, not just being shown by the IDF around Al-Shifa Hospital. This was reporting from Clarissa Ward, who got access to southern Gaza, remember. And she's in a hospital that was set up, a field hospital. So just set up on the fly and arguably one of the last hospitals that's still operating and still taking civilians coming in with injuries. Take a look.
In every bed, another gut punch. Less than 2 years old, Amir still doesn't know that his parents and siblings were killed in the strike that disfigured him. Yesterday, he saw a nurse that looked like his father. His aunt Nahaya tells us he kept screaming, "Dad, Dad, Dad." Amir is still too young to comprehend the horror all around him. But 20-year-old Lama understands it all too well. 10 weeks ago, she was studying engineering at university and helping to plan her sister's wedding. Today, she is recovering from the amputation of her right leg. Her family followed Israeli military orders and fled from the north to the south. But the house where they were seeking shelter was hit in a strike. The world isn't listening to us, she says. Nobody cares about us. We have been dying for over 60 days, dying from the bombing, and nobody did anything.
They did as they were told. They fled northern Gaza and they were bombed in southern Gaza. It is chilling. I'm glad CNN's actually doing some real reporting. Cenk, I wanna move to just what Biden would like to see this week. He sent his national security advisor, Jake Sullivan, to Israel to talk with government officials there and to try to get them to just stop this much bloodshed, right? Don't be so egregious. According to the New York Times, the Biden administration envisions a new phase of the war that would involve the use of smaller groups of elite Israeli forces that would move in and out of the population centers in Gaza, carrying out more precise missions to find and kill Hamas leaders, rescue hostages, and destroy tunnels. That's so cute. That is so beautifully naive, Joe Biden and company. The idea that Israel would do that when they could have done that from day one. And as we've talked about, no, they prefer dropping smart or dumb bombs on civilians, on journalists, on their families, and effectively, I would argue, engage in ethnic cleansing and genocide to wipe Gaza off the map.
Yeah. So first, credit to Clarissa Ward and CNN, terrific report. And for every kid you see there with their face mangled and the dismembered in some cases and their parents lost, etc. Understand that there's 18,000 more like that. So Benjamin Netanyahu is one of the biggest war criminals of my lifetime. The fact that my money goes to help him commit war crimes keeps me up at night. And it should keep us all up at night. Now finally Joe Biden is concerned and telling people the only place he goes, which is fundraisers. That he's worried about the indiscriminate killing of civilians. Well, if you're worried about it, brother, you have a funny way of showing it. Because all he's ever done is greenlight Israel's massacres. Those are solid facts. So now they do this absurd thing that Franny mentioned there. They're saying, no, I know it doesn't look like we're stopping Israel at all, but we're doing quiet diplomacy. Yeah, it's so quiet, no one can hear you. There was a ceasefire resolution in the UN, we vetoed it. Everybody else was on board, we're like, no! No ceasefire, keep killing Palestinians, keep murdering their babies. That's what Joe Biden's administration is saying. Not only that, they're saying we want to spend another $14 billion, another $14 billion of your taxpayer money to murder those kids. And they say no conditions at all. Israel can do anything it wants with the bombs and with the money. Okay, so where's the quiet diplomacy part? Where's the part where you're checking them? You're not checking them at all. You're just doing that for marketing purposes. You know why Biden all of a sudden cares about marketing? Because he's losing Michigan by 10 points. All of a sudden, Joe Biden has found a conscience, or pretending to find a conscience, so he can say, oh, you should see what I'm doing behind the scenes, man. I mean, it looks like I'm greenlighting everything publicly, and I'm trying to send them more money for more massacres with no conditions at all. But trust me, I'm doing diplomacy behind the scenes. No, I don't trust you at all. And at this point, I think you're a monster.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.